Did you know that you can control your garage door, your security system, and your home lighting or door locks from one built-in remote? Because there are several types of remotes out there, I'll give you a few basic tips to get you started on programming, and then I'll direct you to a video that will talk about how to program your specific remote to your universal garage door opener. Let's get started. Before you do anything, you'll need to figure out what sort of universal garage door opener is in your car, and what type of existing transmitter you have. First, let's look at the universal remote on your visor. If yours has three buttons and one LED light, like this one, you have a HomeLink system and will want to go to homelink.com for programming instructions. If your opener has three buttons and three LED lights, you have a car-to-you system and should go to learcartoyou.com. Okay, now let's talk about your original transmitter. If you have a one LED system, you'll need to figure out if you have a Genie IntelliCode or a Genie IntelliCode 2 opener. Once you know, see your owner's manual for specific instructions on how to program your remote. If you have an opener that's made by any other manufacturer, you can also find information on how to program it in your owner's manual. Still with me? Great. Now, if you have a three LED remote, your original transmitter will have either a fixed code or a rolling code. So you'll have to find out what it is before you can program it. To do that, remove the cover. If you see a row of coded switches, you have a fixed transmitter. If you don't see any coded switches, you have a rolling code transmitter. Either way, you'll want to go to your owner's manual for specific instructions. Oh, and one more thing. When you've finished programming your universal opener, make sure to keep your original remote to use with other vehicles, as well as for future programming.